Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn how to create picture paint animation effect in PowerPoint. The beautiful picture paint animation effect you will learn to create today looks like this. First, all you see is a blank screen, and then on a click, the picture gets painted like this. If you want another variation, this is a beautiful variation as well. We will learn how to create this stunning looking picture paint animation effect in PowerPoint from scratch. The first thing you need is some kind of brush stroke graphic which is in SVG format. What I did was I went to Google and searched for brush stroke SVG free and I got a number of options. And the one that I really liked is from this first option. And it says only gfx.com, and when I went to that site, this is what I found, and it is possible for me to download these, and you get not only SVG, you also get a PNG option, both in a zipped folder. When you unzip the folder, you get this brush stroke option, which is in SVG format, and since PowerPoint now allows you to use SVG format, at least from 2016 version forward, you can use SVG document in PowerPoint. I am going to use that option. In case you are using the earlier versions of PowerPoint where you don't have the option to work with the SVG images, then a useful alternative would be to use the shape of a semi-transparent tape. You can find how to create semi-transparent tape with PowerPoint in two of our videos. One is this one, called How to Create PowerPoint Transparent Tape Effects. Another one is PowerPoint Tutorial to Create Semi-Transparent Tape. Both of them teach you the technique of how to create the semi-transparent tape, which has ragged edges, which pretty much mimics this brush stroke graphic. Once you have the SVG image in place, make sure that you right-click and go to Convert to Shape option, and you will get this prompt. You say yes. Now you can use this image as a template to cut your photos in the way that I'm going to explain to you now. Let me go to a new slide and I'm going to insert a picture. The picture that I would like to insert is this one, calendula picture, and I'm going to insert. You can find these pictures from pixabay.com as well. Now I'm going to ensure that this is in 16 by 9 orientation. So I'm going to select this. Go to picture format option, go to crop, go to aspect ratio and say 16:9. And then you click outside and make sure that the top left corner corresponds with the top left corner of the slide. And then click and drag from the bottom right corner. Now you have the image that spans across the entire slide. Now we are going to take the earlier picture, which is in the SVG format, and I'm going to put it right on top of the earlier image, and I'm going to position it in such a way that it covers the top half of the picture. Then I'm going to make a duplicate of this slide because we are going to reuse this combination a couple of times. So now we are working with the duplicate. Now I'm going to select the picture first, then hold the shift button down and click on the SVG image. Then you go to Shape Format option, go to Merge Shapes and say Intersect. Now that ensures that the picture is cropped in the shape of the SVG image that we had just now. Next, we are going to make a duplicate of this slide again. And here I'm going to make a small adjustment in terms of the positioning of this SVG image. I'm going to slightly tilt the angle like so. Now that looks interesting. Now I'm going to do the very same thing. I'm going to take this, hold the shift button down and click on the SVG image. And I'm going to use shape format, merge shapes and intersect. Now I'm going to repeat this once more, duplicate slide. And I'm going to take this and slightly tilt the angle. See, all these are completely up to you. Whatever effect that you want is purely in your hands. Now, the kind of effect that I'm looking for is some kind of a brush actually draws across in a Z pattern. So that is the reason why I've created the first one like this, and the second one like this, and the third one is like this. Now I'm going to select this picture, then the SVG image, go to shape format, merge shapes, and say intersect. Now let us go to a new slide and let us pick up these three images and paste them one next to the other. First, let us take this and I'm going to cut this and I'm going to paste it over here. Then let us go here and then take this and paste it over here. And then let us take this one, cut, and we are going to paste it over here. So this is the way the image will look. Now you can always reposition it the way you want. Now if this is the position that you like, then that is great. Now I'm going to apply custom animation. We have got the first one here. I'm going to apply a very simple wipe animation from left. Then I'm going to select the next one and apply a wipe animation, this time from right, so that it actually goes from here and then this kind of a wipe animation is done. And then the last piece here, wipe animation, and then from left. And let us go to animation pane and ensure that the other two are happening after previous. Now this is the animation sequence. Now for this effect to look even more beautiful, I'm going to have the format background in black color. So I'm going to right click, go to format background. The solid fill that I'm going to use is this black color text one. Now that looks really cool. Let us go to the slideshow mode. On a click, this is how the animation plays. Isn't it beautiful? There is no doubt using animation for your pictures is one of the surefire ways to ensure that your audience pays attention to your presentation. That is the reason why in our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle, we have got a whole bunch of picture animation-based templates. I want to show you a few examples of picture animation-based templates from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. The first example is this one, which reveals the picture with a hand coming in and then showing this picture. You can always replace this picture by just right-clicking, shape fill, and then choose your picture, and this picture gets replaced at the click of a button. It's a very simple process to replace this picture. Of course, with comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle, you will also get a whole bunch of training videos that show you how to use our templates creatively and effectively. Another example of picture-based animation is this one, where we show two pictures and their associated text, which get revealed like this. And these kind of animations definitely will grab the attention of your audience. Another one is three images and text variation. You can see that we have the platform shown, and then we talk about the first image and the associated explanation. Then we go to the next one and to the next one. Another example is three captioned photos that are introduced in a stylish way like this. The next example is this one, where we show three photos and their explanation and see how this picture is in the front and these two are slightly grayed out, and then on a click we draw the attention to the next picture and we reveal the necessary detail, and then we bring in the next picture and we leave the remaining one slightly grayed out. So these kind of effects and so many more are available ready-made in comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. I will leave a link to this useful product in the description box below the video. You can click on the link and check out more details about this really useful product, especially if you are a professional who needs to make presentations as part of your profession. By the way, did you like this video? If you did, then please give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you are a professional and you want to know how to use PowerPoint and Excel creatively, then please hit the subscribe button and also please hit the bell notification so that you can be notified about any new video we post on this channel. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.